Okay, so we have set out here thermal cloak as specified in a video clip I'm going to attach.
Is called radiant barrier material. So write that down, radiant barrier material. Radiant barrier material was developed mainly for insulating homes, but it works extremely well for our thermal suit because it has nearly 95% reflectivity and about the lowest emissivity of any material that we've found on the market today. Okay, so for our first layer, we're going to have a piece of radiant barrier material facing down. All right? That's important. Remember that. The reflectivity should be facing out this way, okay? Or down. The next layer is a thin layer of polyester batting to create airspace. All right? About an inch thick works just fine. Next, we're going to have another piece of radiant barrier material facing the opposite direction from the first layer. All right, so if you look at this, we've created sort of a sandwich here. We have radiant barrier facing this way, polyester batting, radiant barrier facing out the other way. So if all you had to worry about was your hiding your thermal signature, then you would already be finished with the radiant barrier, the polyester batting, and then the radiant barrier on the other side. Unfortunately, you also have to worry about your visual signature and camouflaging that. Now, the second you start to put heavy material on top of this radiant barrier, it's going to start to heat up. And this is the primary problem we ran into with when we were building the suit. Anytime we tried to camouflage it visually, it would start to heat up. Now, we found that if we use extremely light materials over top, like this ripstop nylon material, then your signature is still hidden and it hides your visual signature just enough to do the job. So once you've added the ripstop nylon, you have a pretty good suit. However, you're still going to find that your shape will show up in a regular scope or a thermal scope, that you will have a shape that's discernible, and you want to break up that shape as much as possible. So what we've done is we've added first a layer of sniper veil netting right here, which is extremely light and won't trap the heat at all. Then we've added these camouflage leaves to the netting. We've tied them onto the netting. Now, the camouflage leaves help break up your shape, and if they're made of a light material, what they do is they help redirect any heat that happens to escape from the final layer of your suit.
You have your radiant barrier material layer number one, polyester batting here, and radiant barrier material number two. So, green berry material. You can buy in rolls like this. This is a short, I think 5 foot, maybe 4 foot roll, can't remember. But the longer the roll, the easier it is it's going to be for you to make a thermal suit. So basically what I'm doing here is just roughly attaching it with these. In the past, I did sew together the thermal suit here. I'm going to show you the double stitchings if I can real quick. Move it around here. Alright, so yeah, here. We got some double stitchings right here. And that turned into that thick stitching right there. So those are the really good stitches. Everything else is just stitched along this perimeter and halfway across it to keep it together. But now we got our, I've already been safety pinning it down, as you can see right here. What I'm gonna do with those safety pins, I'm gonna be going out camping with this thing. I don't want anybody to see any sign of me, you never know. Alright, gonna show you how we get the safety pins across. We're gonna use the big ones. Let me make sure I do have them. Back behind the big ones. Alright. I used three big ones to go across. My last one was right here. So we're gonna move about 12 inches down from that. And let me get the tripod off here because I did that lifted up. Okay. So, make sure I got you an angle. Okay. So, you put it through one way, just stick it in there, and then you're going to fold it like this into the needle and push it out through the other side. Real easy. I was pricking my fingers there for a little bit until I figured out the best method to do it. The middle part's always going to be the hardest, so you can... Let me make sure you guys got an angle of that. Okay, you don't. Hold on. In the middle. Okay, got to be further an angle. Alright. Here we go. So you just take the material like that. You feel, make sure that you do have it crimped up here. You're going to start from one side and you're just going to go to the other side of the little V here. There we go. It's through and through. Let's see if you can see that. Yeah. The last one on the right side here. Stretch out my material, make sure it's all nice and flat and even. Well, I'm going to run through these safety pins here for temporary until I get it fully, completely together. What I'm going to run through them is the camouflage material, that cut-up sniper veil. Alright, right now we're about to add on side number two here. We're using olive drab material. I ran out of woodland pattern. Get it squared up at the edges. Right. I'll weigh this down with something. Screws cut off the excess. Make sure you're lined up with your other material. So this is what I'm going to make, call a reversible thermal cloak. Same as before. What we're gonna do is we're almost out of these big ones, so we got some jumbo silver ones here. Gotta get that open. First, so that's also a big one. Some of these big ones are mixed up in there. Okay, turns out I do got some more big ones. Eventually, I want this all sewn together. This is going to require pants, hood attachment, and an extension for the cloak. Right now, it can barely fit over a plate carrier. It does not cover the bottom of a full rucksack. Did one sheet, but now we're cutting out a second sheet for a second half suit. Put up, down, lined up, and then just pull out your length. Cut. Then I got some more polyester batting. See if I got enough for this hole. Nah, probably not. But this is how it comes. Well, not how it comes. Hold on a second. I'm gonna roll out the length of these two. Okay. All right. Don't make the cut. It's about $17 for this roll of polyester batting. About maybe $50 to $100 for radiant barrier material, depending on what kind, what density, what weave you get. The more expensive, the better, generally. But you'll notice that it makes a lot of noise. So, but though I do have, let me show you. I got a piece right here that crinkled up a lot, and it barely makes any noise, especially once polyester batting is in between it, and then also once the fabric is on top of it, so it makes less noise. Then once you got your noise down, all you gotta worry about is thermal checks. Make sure that that suit is working. I do not have a thermal camera to test though. Alright, so we're gonna unroll this, making sure I got two nice even layers of polyester batting. Okay. Bring it up and over. Top edges over here. This is my first layer. So I can slide out the second layer from under. Now I've got the top end secured. I don't got to worry about the polyester batting moving too much while I put this. The extension piece of it, when I do attach it to the suit, will be safety pinned again, and I'll be overlapping it about this much here. So this much will be overlapping on the suit, so it'll be safety pinned in one row and the safety pin on another row on the edge. I might get my friend over here to help me sew this together so you guys can see how that's done. Make sure maybe you have the right thread. I don't know too much about sewing, but my thread just bunches up and it ruins the whole process. All that's left to do is secure these two together and then sew them together.
So let's go try on the suit with all my gear on and we'll see how it works.
You can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Well, my goodness gracious, let me tell you the news. My head's been wet with the midnight dew. I've been down on bended knee, talking to the man from Galilee. He spoke to me with a voice so sweet, I thought I heard the shuffle of angels sweet. He called my name and my heart stood still when he said, John, go do my will. Go tell